Coming to you from 132 Bank Street right here in the city of Suffolk, Virginia. And we're worshiping God this morning.
Hallelujah.
We're giving him glory. We're giving him honor. Hallelujah. He alone is worthy of our praise. And we invite you to come and join us during this next hour or so. The Lord allows us to come to you live.
Glory.
Amen. And we're just thankful for what the Lord has done.
Come
and say, this is the day,
that
the Lord has made. I'm going to rejoice and be glad in it. Come on, give the Lord a praise if you can. Thank God for this day. This is the day that the Lord has made, and we rejoice in it, and we are glad in it. We invite you to continue to like and to share as we go forth in the service on this morning.
Yes.
The Lord has done great things for us, and
hallelujah.
Sometimes it might be raining on the outside. But I say, as long as he is raining on the inside,
yes,
I call it liquid sunshine.
Hallelujah.
Even though it's raining, hallelujah, on the outside, I call it liquid sunshine.
Yes.
The Lord has blessed us to come together
yes.
one more time.
Hallelujah.
And come together in heavenly places
hallelujah.
In Christ Jesus.
Glory.
Continue to like and to share as we go forth in the service on today. We're looking and expecting great
yes.
things of the Lord today. Amen. The Lord has brought us into a brand new month, and
yes.
this is our love month. Amen. And we know
amen.
That God is love.
Yes.
Amen. And we're going to be giving some special shout outs today as we move forward in the service. But now is prayer time.
Yes.
And the Bible
yes.
says that prayer is wont to be made.
Amen.
And that the effectual, fervent prayer of a righteous man, a righteous
yes.
man, availeth much.
Mm.
And I know that prayer works. How many of y'all know prayer works?
Yes.
Hallelujah. It was prayer that brought me here. Prayer brought me here.
Yes.
not any goodness of our own, but it was prayer that brought us here. Yeah. Amen. And I'm going to ask Missionary Wardenia Lassler, she's going to come and offer prayer for us this morning. Let's say amen for her as she comes.
Let us pray this morning. Father God, in the name of Jesus, God, we thank you this morning. God, we thank you, we thank you, we thank you. Hallelujah to your name. Oh, bless your name this morning. Oh, God, we thank you, God, for our lives on today, God. We thank you for being here on today, God. We thank you, oh, God, for protecting us, oh, God, over the dangerous highways, oh, God. Lord, we thank you this morning, oh, God. We give you glory, oh, God. We give you praise, oh, God.
Is in the law of the Lord, and in his law doth he meditate day and night. And he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water that bringeth forth his fruit in his season. His leaf also shall not wither, and whatsoever he do shall prosper. The ungodly are not so, but are like the chaff which the wind driveth away. Therefore, the ungodly shall not stand in judgment, nor sinners in the congregation of righteousness. For the Lord knoweth the way of the righteous, but the way of the godly shall perish. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading of his word.
Amen. Come on, let's talk to the Lord. Thank you. Amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. We're thankful for what the Lord has done. God has done great things for us. Amen. And we're glad. Somebody said, let the redeemed of the Lord say so. Who we have redeemed is on the head of the enemy. Hallelujah. God has done great things for us. We thank God for each of you that have joined us on this morning. Thank God for the press in your soul, and the old folks used to say there's a blessing in your pressing. We didn't just press our way through the rain just because we had nothing better to do. Amen. We could have laid in our bed, but I say, God, I believe you've got something that I need to hear. You got something yet in store for me. And I believe that God's going to give it that which you have great in need of right now. Hallelujah. Thank God for Jesus. Come on, bless the Lord tonight. God got great things in store for us. Hallelujah. Amen. Wait upon the Lord. He shall renew your strength. He'll have you to mount up with wings as eagle. Have you to run and not be weary. Have you to walk and not faint. Hallelujah, he's there all the time. Come on, let's celebrate and thank God for the victory. Thank God for the victory. Amen, hallelujah. We ask that you would continue to join us and to like and to share. Tell your friends and loved ones that we're on the air. Amen, we mean Jesus 100%. I believe God is delivering folk and setting folk free even as we speak. Somebody, hallelujah, want more of Jesus. He said more in 24. Can you help us say more in 24? Amen. We're looking for God's more. Amen. This is our year of provision and a year of abundance. And we are claiming it right now in Jesus' name. Amen. If I would thank God for me. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. That's all right. Give it a praise. Hallelujah. We got time. Take a little time out to bless the Lord on my soul. Bless my enemy. Bless his holy name. Bless his name. Bless his and bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Amen. Amen. Thank God for his presence. Thank God for what he's doing. Hallelujah. In our midst. Can't nobody. Help us say, can't nobody. Do you like Jesus? Can't nobody. Hey. Hallelujah. Do you like the Lord? Hallelujah. For what we give him praise. And for that cause, we give him glory.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah. Thank God for you that will join us on this morning. God is up to something. How do y'all believe God is up to something? I believe God is up to something. And he's in the blessing and delivering business. So we thank God for what he's doing in our midst. And we ask that you would join us in our weekly services here at the church. And we do, I'll give you the announcements, because we do intend for to have you to be a part of what the Lord is doing. I believe God is speaking to our heart in unique ways and giving us the will to do it, how to do it. And we're just trusting him even now sometimes when it doesn't seem like we can trace that. But heaven said, God is there.
God is there.
So we celebrate with you on this morning. By way of announcements, we would like to mention, of course, that we're in the month of February, and there's so much that goes on in the month of February. It's the heart month. Amen. And so many other things is happening. Valentine's. Amen. Bless God for all of the lovers. Amen. But you know it's for lovers. If you didn't know that, you know it now. Virginia is for lovers, and we do put a special emphasis on that. And because not only that, but God is love.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Yes.
And love is God. So we do show forth the love toward our brothers and sisters, and we celebrate with those persons that are celebrating their birthday in this month of February.
Yes.
We didn't get an opportunity to do it last week, but this week, of course, we're going to make sure that we mention that Brother Kaheem Rogers begins us out with our birthday celebration on the 5th of February. God bless Brother Kaheem. Amen, Brother Noah. Amen. I call him Brother Noah. Amen. My brother's 14th. He's a Valentine, baby. Amen, Brother Noah Williams on the 14th, and his mother as well. This is Felicia. Sister Felicia, Sister T. Williams on the 14th of February. And not only that, our very own daughter, amen, Sister Jewel Lassiter on the 15th of February. Amen. So let's celebrate with our family. Amen. And we can encourage you, if you're born in the month of February, let us know. And we like to try to do that as a special cause, shout out, to let them know we love you and we encourage you to keep on having birthdays. Because somebody said, as long as you're having birthdays, you're doing okay. Amen. So keep on having birthdays. And let the Lord bless you as you mature. Amen. You're not getting older, but you're getting better. And we thank God for the maturity that's been shown, even among those young people that some names I've called out. I see the growth and see the maturity that's coming in their lives. So we thank God for them as well. And as of course, we cannot forget Black History Month. This is the month of our Black History celebration. But I contend to say that Black History is every day. And that you cannot, come on y'all. You cannot truthfully celebrate American history without including Black history as a part of it. So we are American history. Come on, tell somebody, we are American history. The story will not be told right until they have included us in their annals of time. Amen? So we thank God for that, and we all will have a Black History moment. We have a lot of things that we're doing on today, and my wife is going to come, and just as a highlight, she's going to come and share with us some Black history information. I think it's so vital to us and from the health wellness standpoint. So let's say amen for Missionary Irma Carter. She's coming at this time. I'm going to give her her very own special mic.
Amen.
Amen. God bless you.
Praise the Lord. Good morning, everyone. And as we celebrate this month of love, we also celebrate heart disease among Black women and Latino women. And just want you to know, by way of information, the number one killer of women is heart disease.
Yes.
More than half of all heart attacks are victims of women.
Yes.
Yet most of the women don't know that heart disease is their biggest health threat.
Yes.
Okay, more women die of a heart disease than breast cancer.
Yes.
Amen. There's some of the symptoms, ladies, and we love ourselves and we want to take heed to our bodies.
Yes.
Jaw pain. Dizziness, excessiveness, ma'am. Dizziness, lightheadedness, shortness of breath, racing heart, discomfort or burning in the chest or the back, nausea, vomiting, tingling down one's arms or legs.
Yes.
These are some symptoms we should take note of. Amen. And besides being the number one killer since 1984, the number one cardiovascular disease death for women has exceeded more than men.
Yes.
90% of women have one or more risk factors developing.
Right.
Amen. And as being of an ethnic group, we know, we joke about it, but we know,
right.
Love ourselves and let's take care of ourselves.
Amen.
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 Come on, let's give us an amen. Amen. She is my nurse. Amen.
Yes.
She is a retired nurse, and so I get it from both sides. Amen.
Yes.
Trying to keep me straight. So thank God for that information, and we do need to take care of ourselves. Amen.
Yes.
So thank you, First Lady. We thank God for all of the input of these young ladies. We have a lot of professionals here at the church.
Yes, sir.
They have had some input, and they're helping us, and we've got some things that's planned in the near future. We'll be giving you some highlights so that we can be more helpers of one another. In our community, amen?
Amen.
Because we got to take care of ourselves,
amen.
Don't we? God does something, but we also are responsible for doing something.
That's right.
For taking care of ourselves. So thank God for you, First Lady. Also, by way of announcements, I'd like to finish that this, of course, this Sunday is our second Sunday of our Ladies Sunday, and they've been, of course, we incorporated in part of our service, not just on this Sunday alone, but all during the month and all during the year, they're part of the service.
Yes, sir.
I don't want them to ever to feel that they're left out.
Amen.
Because I tell you, I would not be in a church with all men.
Amen.
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 Amen. Thank God for the brother, but I thank God for the fragrances of the women and how they help flower the house of God. Come on, let's thank God for these ladies. Amen. So I thank God for that input. So by way of announcements, we'd like you to know that you are invited to any and all of our services. Of course, our services start with prayer on our Sunday school hour at 9 o'clock on Sunday morning. And we invite you to come and be a part of the Sunday school as we share the word of the Lord. And it's been some very interesting topics that we've been talking about in our Sunday school. But it begins at 9 o'clock. So join us at the 9 o'clock hour. And then at the 10:30 hour, we are engaged in our morning worship service and our morning worship celebration experience. We ask that you come and be a part of that as well. I don't know about you, but I'm looking for God to do even greater things as we move forward in the services. Because if he's not there, I will not be there. But if the Lord is there, I want to be wherever Jesus is. And wherever he is, there is liberty. So be a part of the service. It begins at 10:30 a.m. And we continue until the Lord lets us go and we go off the air. But then on Tuesday, y'all help me say Tuesday.
Tuesday.
On Tuesday, we are in the celebration, of course, on our Tuesday night Bible study at the 7:30 p.m. hour.
Amen.
But on Tuesday morning at 12 noon, we're praying on our intercessory prayer group. I call it joining together. And the Lord has been blessing the prayer ministry on the 12 noon hour. And you can go right to our website address. And that is www.hgocogic.com. And there are call letters that's listed on your screen right now. Join us, and we do have a lot of people that join us that not even in the state of Virginia, but throughout these United States and even into South America. We thank God, and we do say bonus dias to you this morning. They join us each and every week, and we thank God for them. Amen. Praying for them. Amen. Just Michelle here. We pray for her. She connects with us equal high as a family, as Miss Irma. I said, she do it well. I said, amen. And she just says, gracias, gracias. And I said, thank God for her. Amen.
Amen.
So we are connecting with them. And that's the God that we serve. He's the God of every nation.
Yes.
And that's his name. And he understands them when I can't quite understand them. He knows their needs as well. He knows our needs as well. So keep them in your prayers as we move forward. And that prayer session takes place at 12 noon, not only on Tuesday, but also at the Friday at the same hour at 12 o'clock. And go to the same website address, www.hgocogic.com. Did I get it right that time? Amen. So we thank God also for those that are contributing to us. And you have been doing a tremendous job. I was doing some research and looking. Amen. Come on, thank God for you. Amen. We're not in the red. Praise God. And I said, as long as we're not in the red, we're halfway doing halfway right. So I thank God for each and every one of you, all of your contributions, and those that have given the tithes and offering. And it is something that is necessary to keep the body of Christ and keep the church going on. Those that are contributing, you may do it right now. As we're talking, you can go right to your website address, and you can go right to your Giblify app. Amen. And go right to the Giblify app. And we're 132 Bank Street right here in the city of Suffolk. You can join us at just we're the only one that's at 132 Bank Street at the High Ground Church. And so make your contributions now while I'm talking. I received some even on this morning. And those of you that'll give by to Cash App, you can go to $CCEFC and you can do it that way as well. And otherwise you can also do it as you come across the table. We're gonna be receiving our offering a little later on during the service. But we thank God for your support.
Yes,
amen.
Sir.
Your loyal support. Even during the pandemic, it seems like our numbers went up. Just a little bit, amen. So I say, even because it's something that we do because it's right to do. The Bible says, give, and it shall be given unto you. Good measures, pressed down, shaken together, and what? Running over shall men give unto your bosom. For with the same measure that ye mete out, it shall be measured to you again. So we're so thankful and grateful for all of our ministering brothers. Amen. Thank God for Ella Eden.
Amen.
And for all of the mothers that are here on this morning. We had a beautiful session on yesterday. We had our 3M meeting, which is men mentoring men. Amen. So we were excited. We had breakfast, and the brethren just got together, and we did some men talk. Sometimes men need to talk and talk about some stuff. Because contrary to popular opinion that men don't talk, them brothers were talking yesterday. So I Oh my God. Amen. But sometimes we keep things bottled in.
That's right.
But you'd be surprised at the help, because that's iron right. does indeed sharpen iron.
Yes, sir.
We had some sharpening going on yesterday.
Yes, sir.
Amen. Right. In our session. So we're going to set another date. Amen. We don't want to let that be the one and only time. We that's don't want right. to be a one hit wonder. Amen. Amen. But we want to continue that thing,
that's
because
right.
we didn't get it all out on yesterday.
Uh-huh.
But we're working on it.
Yes, sir.
And I think it's going to be a blessing to these young men that we're trying to raise and trying to nurture up. And some we've got issues, and y'all
yes,
might
sir.
As well admit the fact
Amen.
That sometimes because of societal, we got societal issues,
yeah.
issues that come up just because we who we are.
Yeah.
And if we don't talk about it, we bottle these things up. I think sometimes we would be doing ourselves a disservice if we don't talk about some stuff.
Right.
We're talking about mental health issues.
Right.
We don't want to go off on the deep end. They're
That's
talking
right.
about taboo stuff that really
yeah.
the folk don't want to talk about.
Talk about
but
it.
I say, if you can't get educated in the church, where you going to get educated at? Can't depend on it. I don't want to start preaching it early. But where you go, you can't get it from the street.
Yes,
sir. Amen. Because street would not only give you God's perspective
Amen.
And God's standard for
yeah.
your life.
Yeah.
And it's going to bless your life. So men, join us on next week. Not next week. I can't do it next week.
Uh-huh.
But we're going to give you another date.
Yes, sir.
We'll be able to get together
Amen.
And be able to share with you what the Lord has laid on our heart.
Amen.
So we're grateful for this Black History Moment. We thank God for this opportunity to share the gospel message. But before I come, I want this young lady to come, and she's going to share and give us a selection this morning, and we'll be back with the word from the Lord. Come on,
amen.
Sister Dr. Amen. Jordan is going to come. Let's say amen for her as she comes.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Take your time, though.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Thank thee now.
Yes.
I pray that this song blesses you,
yes.
encourages you,
yes.
and reminds you. Made
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God, my help coming from the Lord. Come on, give God a praise if you can. Thank you, Jesus. My help comes from the Lord. Glory to God. Glory to God. Thank God for help. God knows where we need help. Hallelujah. God knows where we need help at. Sometimes that help just says help, Lord. And when you can say help, Lord, how many of y'all can just say help, Lord? That we, hallelujah. That reaches everything. God knows when you need help at. Sometimes you can't tell nobody else, but you can say help, Lord. Yeah, sometimes that's all you can say is help, Lord. Hallelujah. And God knows where we need help at. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hey, hallelujah. I help come from the Lord. Glory to God. To God be the glory for the great things that He has done. Amen. I know where my help comes from. I'm going to look up my eyes to the heat from which cometh my help.
Yes, sir.
When I can't get help from anyone else, my help comes from the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen. We're praying in particular for Mother Shirley Jefferson. She lost her brother on this past week. My brother David Hill, and we're praying for her and her family that God will help them. He helps us through our grief and through our bereavement, doesn't He? God help us. Hallelujah. God helps us through our sicknesses and through our trials and tribulations. God has a way of helping His people. Thank you, Jesus. I won't take nothing for my help. Amen. Thank God for His favor upon our lives. Can't nobody do you like the Lord. So we're celebrating this morning. Thank you, Jesus. Well, thank you, Dr. Jordan, for the help that God sends our way. Amen. God's not going to talk about you. He will help you. Keep you moving. Keep right on going. Amen. Hallelujah. And I thank God for the help that He has supplied. Thank God for strengthening the bodies of these young people, these young babies. Of course, we've all been dealing with some type of infirmities in our bodies these last few months, the changing of the weather and the hot and cold. But God has helped us. Heaven said, God has helped us.
Yes, sir.
And He helped us through those times by which we didn't know exactly what to do. I went to the drugstore yesterday. I said, I got to get some old remedies out of Eden.
Yes, sir.
I said, I don't want to go too far and take it too far, but went back and reached back and get some Creole motion and reached back and I saw the 3 sixes on the shelf.
Yes, sir.
I backed up off of the Father John. I said, I don't want to go back that far, but I looked at the castor oil and some of the other remedies and God knows. We might have to go back to some of that strange, y'all, because that helped us, and we didn't realize how much it was helping us when we was coming through. Our parents made it necessary, it's mandatory, that during the change of the seasons, we had the castor oil, we had the caprophenic, we had the sweet oil. Y'all don't know nothing about the sweet oil. And the crib motion, and sometimes even the Father John 3 sixes. But I guarantee you, we were not as sick as we were are now back then. And then deal with some of the infirmities that we're dealing with now. But God is our help. He has helped us through those periods. And I'm grateful for being able to stand behind the sacred desk on today. And I just feel a special anointing that God's going to deliver somebody today. Somebody's going to get set free today. Help me say today. I believe God's going to help somebody today. Hallelujah. That's the hallelujah. That's the type of God that we serve. He's a right now God. Yes, He is. So God bless you. Those of you that are listening to us by way of Facebook, we pray that God will speak to your heart and speak to your mind as well. Get your Bibles. We're going to share with you for the next few moments that the Lord gives us audience on this morning. Of course, we ask that you would pray for us, that God would anoint us.
Yes, sir.
Because without the anointing, then we're just like any other man. So I thank God for His anointing. Thank God for His presence. And thank God for you that have come out here this day. And we pray that your coming would not be in vain.
Hallelujah.
Amen. That's my prayer. Lord, let not my coming be in vain. Because the bed looked real good, didn't it? Y'all got quiet. Y'all know the bed looked real good. Amen. And we've got all the celebrations, and some of you have some Super Bowl parties and all planned for later on. But thank God they moved it back to late during the day. So we don't have to encroach on that time. So you don't have to rush out, because I know it don't come on till 6 o'clock. So don't y'all try to pull the wool on my eyes. Amen. God bless you, Mother. Didn't know you were here. God, thank God for Mother Jefferson. Come on. Amen. I didn't know she was here. talking to her about the loss of her brother, and we're praying for the healed family, and we're praying for her and the Jefferson family. The Lord will strengthen them during their time of bereavement. Amen. God does help us, doesn't he?
He does.
And he helps us in that right early. Get your Bible, and I want you to turn to the book of Job. And I want to talk about, this is a very familiar passage of scripture, but I thank God for revelation. And God gives us revelation when we go back and revisit the scriptures, and we don't get it all the first time. Sister Jasmine, when we go back and research it, we're like the Bereans. We go back and search and whether these things be so or not.
That's right.
Even as the preaching of the gospel was being done in the book of Acts, the Bereans were a special group of people that went back and searched the scriptures to find out after the preaching was concluded. They went back and got their book and they searched those things to see whether they be so or not. So that's what my encouragement is for you today. I want you to go back and check it out.
Yes, sir.
And search this, what we're talking about on today. So we're going to talk about keep doing what you're doing until you see God turn it around. So help me say, keep doing what you're doing until you see God turn it around. So I want to encourage somebody today. The word faith, and as we talk, it deals with faith. And Job was a man of faith. You've heard of the patience of Job and the faith of Job. But the word faith means to believe or to trust. And we've been dealing with some basic tenets of biblical of doctrine this past few weeks and principles that we have been discussing of late about returning back to the basics. Help me say, we got to go back to basics. That's the foundational thing that helped make us strong. And I believe it'll be well worth our time and effort to revisit these types of doctrines.
Yes, sir.
The doctrine of faith. The Bible says, for without faith, it is impossible, not probable, it's impossible to please God.
Right.
And then this text that I'm going to read, Job, the second chapter, verses 7 through 13. I think I'll read that, and y'all know I won't read the first portion of that, but beginning at verse 7, and I'll be reading from the King James Version. So went Satan forth from the presence of the Lord. You say, I don't know, the devil visited God, but if this is what the scripture just read, then went Satan forth from the presence of the Lord and smote Job with sore boils from the sole of his foot unto his crown, or the top of his head. And he took him a potsherd to scrape himself withal. And he sat down among the ashes. I want y'all to get the picture. Then said his wife unto him, doth thou still retain thine integrity? Curse God and die. But he said unto her, thou speakest as one of the foolish women speaketh. What? Shall we receive good at the hand of God? And shall we not receive evil? And all this did not Job sin with his lips.
My God.
Now, when Job's three friends heard of all this evil that was come upon him, they came every one from his own place. Eliphaz, the Temanite, and Bildad, the Shuhite, and Zophar, the Naamathite. For they had made an appointment together to come to mourn with him and to comfort him.
My God.
And when they lifted up their eyes afar off and knew him not, they couldn't recognize him. They lifted up their voice and cried and wept. And they rent every one his mantle and sprinkled dust upon their heads toward heaven. So they sat down with him upon the ground 7 days and seven nights, and none spake a word unto him, for they saw that his grief was very great.
Oh my God.
I say this as a footnote. Sometimes life can leave you speechless.
Yes, sir.
You don't know what to say. And my mother told me that if you don't want to know what to say, don't say what?
Nothing.
She's put it this way. If you don't have anything good to say, don't say nothing. But sometimes we can have such circumstances that come upon us that makes it difficult for us to formulate the words to try to describe it. They came and saw him in this condition. So Job is suffering, not because he has done anything evil, But know this, beloved, going through rough things doesn't mean that you are a bad person.
That's right.
Can I say that again?
Yes, sir.
Going through rough things doesn't mean that you're a bad person.
All right.
And sometimes we can get that thing misconstrued. We think you must be suffering because you did something wrong.
My God.
But in Job's case, and many of our cases, it's not that we've done anything wrong, but it's just God's testing time. Something God allows for his own purpose and will because he is sovereign. Help me say God is sovereign. Commentators say this concerning Job's suffering. It lasted about 9 months. I don't know how they came up with a numerical date or section of time or period of time, but they say it lasted about 9. That's still a long time to be suffering. Amen. To one day in suffering can be a bad, seem like a lifetime. But this suffering lasted about 9 months, and the book of Job is made up of approximately 42 chapters over a period of 9 months. It is considered to be the oldest book in the Bible. Now, the law had not been given at the time of his writing, but the principles are universal. So we look, he doesn't mention Abraham, because we know that Abraham was the progenitor of the Hebrews at the beginning of God's people, as we know of Israel. There is no mention of Israel. So therefore, it is classified as one of the oldest or the oldest book in the Bible. Now, notice this, that in this, we're very familiar that Job is under attack. Y'all will agree upon that. And when you're under attack, you're going to get a revelation of a couple of things. And I want y'all to hear me out this morning. You either are going to get a revelation of the integrity of your own faith, and or number two, you're going to get a revelation of the integrity of the relationships around you. When you're going through, you'll find out who your real friends are. And I'm talking to anybody this morning. Because as long as the sun is shining, you got plenty of money, things are going your way. Sometimes we got what we call fair weather friends. But as soon as the tables are turned and they see you really not going in the direction that they want to go with you up, they will sometimes leave you alone. But we look at these friends as they come to visit Job, and they become miserable comforters as they come, and their intention was to comfort him. But we see they're lashing out accusations against him as the story goes on. And when you are under attack, the enemy tries to come in when your reality does not match your possibility. Can I say that again?
Yes, sir.
When you're under attack, and I've been under attack, and some of us are under attack right now. It's a classic opportunity for the enemy to come in, and your reality does not match up with your possibility. Because you see with your eyes what you're going through. And you might say, God, how could you allow this to happen to me if you really, sure enough, love me? And it doesn't match up. You say, many are the affliction of the righteous, but the Lord delivered them out of them all. God, why at this time are you allowing this evil to access me? After all, I paid my tithes, I've come to church, I've been faithful. God, how could you? Good God Almighty, how could you? What? How does this look? This is not a good look for me. And sometimes as I look at Job's situation, it can be embarrassing to be a saint. Y'all don't have to go along with that. Sometimes God can put you in some very embarrassing situations. And you don't know what to say and how to say it. But Job is under attack. So the question becomes, can you still believe God in that particular place? Can you still trust God after all of that what you've done previously? And I thank God for Elder Eden. He did an extensive survey and overview and summary of the book of Job. And I'm still getting some insights coming from that particular exposition that he gave. I said, okay, I'm looking at it from a different way now. So as I look at it, he's under attack. And then the enemy has come in and made his claim and says, well, look at what you say. I know what the Bible says, but look at you. Maybe y'all ain't had that comparison.
Yes,
I know what the Bible says, that you're the head and not the tail, but look at you.
Yes, sir.
Look where you are right now. I know that there is no weapon that's going to get you, but look at you right now. So sometimes our reality doesn't match up with our possibility. Job is in that state at this time. So in the text, God has allowed Satan to attack Job's family and all of his possessions And now he's coming after Job's health. Skin for skin. Y'all heard his accusation.
Yes, sir.
All the man give for his own body.
Uh-huh.
And there's no attack like an attack on your body.
My God.
And I'm speaking from experience now.
Uh-huh.
See, God, I'm praying for folks. For folks getting healed, folks getting delivered. Why am I feeling bad? Mm. Hallelujah. Why am I having to go through this? Mm. But God has a way that sometimes the enemy attacks our health.
Yes.
Boils all over his body. I want y'all to get the picture.
Yes.
And when historians talk about Job's physical condition, Job had blood and pus oozing from his body.
Yes.
And guess what? It's on his birthday.
My God.
Yes.
Sitting on an ash pile.
Yes.
He is weak all over. And his condition is worse than leprosy.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Job is in excruciating pain.
My God. Yes.
But what can we learn from this? Mm. It is one thing to go through privately.
Mm.
But then it's a whole other ballgame to go through things publicly.
Yes, sir.
My God.
Because now everybody
says,
Lord, what are they going to say?
Yes.
And we're always concerned about what people say about us.
Right.
Because after all, we represent God.
Amen.
God, how could I be your child? My reality is not equal enough to what's going on at this present time. So Job and his everybody's watching him.
Mm.
Tell somebody, sometimes
being a saint
can place you in some embarrassing
situations.
Because you want to maintain your integrity. You don't want to flesh out on nobody when they're putting the pressure on you. You don't want to start cussing them and giving a piece of your sober mind.
That's right.
But you're placed in a situation, they said that you're supposed to turn the other cheek. And why are you putting this kind of pressure on me to test me to see if I'm going to turn the other cheek?
Uh-huh.
But sometimes you're placed in that situation. And holding your peace becomes even more difficult because you already formulated in your mind what you could and should have said.
Oh, yes.
Y'all not going to be real with me this morning.
Yes.
But that's what the devil said, that what you should have told her.
That's right.
What you should have, y'all ain't being real with me this morning. What you should have told him, and sometimes, you know, they shake their head, and they don't put that, y'all don't hear me this morning. And they put their hand on their hip, you about to get it, brother. You about to get it, sister. But that is the time that we've got to trust God to help us to hold our peace. Because somebody said, if you hold your peace, what will happen for you? The Lord will fight your battles. So Job gives us some strategies for our struggles. But know this, beloved, if you can't be tested, you can't be trusted.
All right.
God has special things restored for us, and sometimes we fail the test.
Mm-hmm.
So if you can't be tested, you really can't be trusted. They used to have a saying back in the day that, I can't think of the name, but before the name goes on, the integrity goes in before the name goes on. Some kind of bottle was Zenith. Before the name goes on, the integrity goes in. So you could trust the Zenith TV if you ever purchased one back in the day. I don't know if they're still making them or not. But that was their slogan. That was their motto that they used to let the people know that they had a quality product because it had been tested. So if so is the case with us. The test put Job's faith to the test on many different levels. He's in pain. Hallelujah. His house is torn up, and his kids are dead, and his wife is a bit off in her spirit.
Mm.
But watch this, beloved, and this is what the Lord gave me even last night. We talk about Job's losing all these things, his cattle, his camels and she asses and his servants, his children, but Job was married.
Yes, yes.
So we don't talk about Mrs. Job.
Uh-huh.
The wife lost these things too.
Yes, she did.
She did. Yes. Said so.
They were her kids too. So don't be so down on sister Job. This girl went through something with him. And sometimes we don't take into account that when we go through, people around us go through as well. Y'all not going to talk back to me this morning. We don't take into account that when you hurt, people around us are sometimes hurt. So we get critical sometimes. We say, Job lost everything he had. All the cattle and everything he had. But what about Sister Job?
Yes, sir.
Y'all not going to talk back to me. They were her children too. She was part and parcel of the wealth that he had accumulated. No cattle, no camel, no servant. Now you done killed my children. Hallelujah. Oh, thank you, Jesus. So she gets to Job and basically says, you mean to tell me that after all that we have gone through, you still worried about your integrity?
Yes.
After that, we've endured. Job, what's going on, man? Y'all, I'm just
praying. That's good.
I'm in this with you.
Yes.
I'm hurt because you hurt.
Yes, sir.
Y'all not talking back.
Yes,
we got to consider that. We can be so inconsiderate sometimes because all I've ever really thought about was Job. And I'm going to be honest with you because that's what we push.
Yes.
But what about his wife?
Yes. That's right.
You going through, but sometimes we are attached to other people.
Yes.
Y'all with me, amen? Job went through too. So that made me get a different perspective on what she said.
Yes, sir.
Why don't you get it over with and stop the bleeding, so to speak?
Uh-huh.
Sometimes you can go hallelujah through so much till you want to say, what can I do to stop this?
Uh-huh.
And she feel that if you die, maybe it'll all stop.
My God.
Why don't you curse God and die?
Yes.
Why are you worried about your integrity at this venture?
Uh-huh.
We've lost everything.
My God.
We have nothing to start over with again. From that mistake. But I'm saying this. Keep doing what you're doing.
Uh-huh.
Y'all with me this morning?
Yes,
until God turns it around. So she's looking at it. So don't they feel it too? How frustrating it must have been that of all the places that now she have offered, which have offered the greatest comfort, would have been his home.
Yeah.
It becomes a place of his greatest struggle.
Yes.
I'm home and now I'm with my wife. And then I got to struggle with her too.
Uh-huh.
Oh my God. His wife should have been his greatest intercessor.
Mm-hmm.
But because of what she is also going through, she becomes his greatest interrogator.
Uh-huh.
Y'all with me this morning?
Yes,
come on.
I feel this thing in my spirit. He really should have got some comfort from her. But now she's saying, wait a minute.
Uh-huh.
That's right.
We'd all have been through this.
Yes.
Why don't you curse God? Why are you worried about your integrity at such a time as this?
Yes.
She becomes his critic.
Yes.
But Job responds and says, "He meant to tell me this, that all you mean to tell me that all that God has blessed us with and done for us, you want me to give up and die?"
Uh-huh.
I'm just paraphrasing it. That's really what he was saying.
Uh-huh.
What are you talking about? I thought. And I look at it, and God has blessed us, hasn't he?
Yes, he has.
But then when we get experience a period of bad things, we want to turn cold and change God.
That's right.
But Job kept his interpretation because he did not curse God.
His lips did not curse God.
Yeah.
And when we speak of cursing, and I want to make this crystal clear because we sometimes miss the biblical meaning.
Uh-huh.
When they speak of cursing in the Bible, it's not saying bad words.
That's right. Amen.
That's right.
That some of us do.
No,
uh-huh.
But it's talking about speaking against.
Yeah, that's right.
He spoke against the day that he was born. He said, I would I had never been born.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. He didn't curse God with his lips. Nor by he just started cussing God out. So don't y'all try. Look at somebody and say, don't even try that. It's not going to work for you. But when Jesus cursed this fig tree, he didn't give him some expletive. But he spoke against his fig tree and said, you will bear no more fruit from this day forth. And the next day, y'all help me say the next day, when the disciples came, they looked at the fig tree and said, Lord, the fig tree which thou cursed is dried up. And all Jesus says is that you won't bear no more fruit. Because at the time of fig, you had none. You ain't no good for nothing. Dry on up and going about your business. So he wasn't using expletive, as sometimes we are prone to do, but he spoke against him. And God said he didn't speak against him the whole time that he was going through, but he maintained his integrity.
Yes, he did.
So Job responds to him and tells him, because then when trouble comes, some folk feel that death is better than life. And I don't know how many of you have been in a very intense crisis situation, but it seems like death is a better option than living.
Amen.
And you say, if I could just relieve the pressure, if I could relieve the suffering, I will be okay.
Yes, sir.
But that's not always the best way out.
Right.
God has another way. Come on, somebody talk back to me. God has another way. And if you can just hold out, God has a blessing with your name on it. I was telling myself the other day at the desk, I was looking. I said, Lord, I want to hold out to the end to see how it looked.
Yes.
I don't want to give up in the process because I want to get all the way to the end because I'm curious to see how victory, showing up victory looks. So I can't give up now. Tell me, if I can't give up now. I got to see what the end looks like. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I've got to see what the end looks like. When I've gone through my trials, when I've fought my lion and killed my bear, and I'm still standing. Yes. Come on, y'all. God has brought us. Good God Almighty. Woo, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I want to see. I want to see what it looks like if I don't give up. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, give God a praise. Oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. I want to see what it looks like if I can hold out unto the end.
Yes.
God has something special in store for you.
Yes, he does.
Tormented as though he was, Job expresses a genuine faith in God.
Yes.
Some stuff only God can help us.
Right.
Hallelujah. And I was talking on yesterday, I said, what God wants us to do, we can do the possible. But some of this impossible stuff, we're going to have to leave up to God. You can't solve everything. Now, listen to this real quickly. Then I'm going to bring it in a few moments. Amen. I'm getting hot and happy up here. But I got to keep it moving. Job was in a critical place. He was in a place where he had to mature from a place of, watch this, situational faith based on conditions to a place of adaptational faith. Situational faith is a faith based on conditions. As long as this happens, then I can make it. As long as that happens, I can make it. But don't add trouble, insult to injury, and while I'm going through, add another trouble. And I don't know how many of you have experienced that. Before you can get through one issue, here comes another.
Yes.
And sometimes we're not able to survive it because, Lord, as what the Lord gives us an assurance, he said, I will put no more on you than you can bear. So if God brought you to it, come on, help me talk back to me. If God brought you to it, y'all not talking, help me say this. If God brought you to it, God will bring you through it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm a witness. Because I wanted to question God. I said, Lord, I don't really need this. I could have did without this. Come on, let's keep it real, y'all. I will still serve you. You didn't have to do this. You didn't have to allow this to happen. But that was, I had to learn how to adapt. And this is the type of faith that I'm talking about. It is intact as long as certain things exist. That's situational faith. As long as certain things exist, I'm okay. I can make it. I might have a headache. I'll get through that. Might have a toe ache. I'll get through that. Might have some body. I'll get through that. But let it compound itself.
Yeah.
Let death come in.
Yes.
Let discouragement come in.
Yes.
Let folk walk away from you that were so-called friends while you're in it and need them the most. Let that happen.
That's right. She's right.
And see if you will make the adaptation. If you can adapt. If you can adjust. To say if everybody walks away. If everybody walk away, Lord, I'm still going to love you.
Yes.
Hallelujah, I'm still going to serve you.
Yes.
Though mother and father forsake me, I'm going to still trust you. I'm going to trust you even when I cannot trust you. I don't know who I'm talking to this morning, but I don't just want situational faith. I want the other kind, but adaptational, let me make it plain, is a faith that says even though the circumstances are not conducive to my ideal reality, I'm going to still stay with you.
I hear you.
I'm going to still stick with you because you've been faithful to me. Hallelujah. Adaptational faith. Glory to God has this. I'm going to stay with you. It says I'm fully persuaded that you can do what you said you could do. It is the saints, if not clause, and I put that in there. It's the saints, even if I don't get delivered, I'm still going to trust you. Even though my situation, even though boils and sores are from the top of my head to the soles of my feet, I'm going to maintain my integrity. Because I say the Lord giveth and the Lord taketh away. Bless it.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah. Job had adaptational faith. He adapted to his situation.
Yes.
And did not curse God. That says even though it doesn't, if he don't do it, if he do it or if he doesn't do it, I'm still going to trust him.
Oh my God.
That's that adaptational faith. And I heard the Hebrews boys hear it saying, even after they were about to be thrown into the burning fiery furnace, their faith was still strong.
Yes,
hallelujah. I read the story. They believed that their God was going to intervene on their behalf. They tell the king in Daniel, the third chapter, I want y'all to look at it real quick. Get excited. Because I always got an if not clause. That's the disarming clause that the devil think he got over you. Says, well, you trust in God. Suppose he don't do it. I say, but suppose he does. And if he doesn't do it, I'm still going to trust him. May not come when I want it, but I know. But that if not clause. Every saint of God needs an if not clause. It's a disarming factor to the enemy. As I look at Daniel, the third chapter, I'm getting excited, that 18th verse. But if not, be it known unto thee, O king, that we will not serve thy gods, nor worship the golden image which thou hast set up. Every child of God needs an if not clause. And y'all know the rest of that story. Even if they don't, that infuriated the king. He said, throw them in there. They just told me they weren't going to serve my God regardless. And they threw them in there. And there come Jesus. Good God Almighty. Because they dared to defy the king's order. Because praying got them in trouble. And guess what? Praying got them out of trouble. So look at somebody and say, keep doing what you're doing. Until God turn your situation around. I feel the Holy Ghost. Keep doing what you're doing. Until God turn your situation around. I know he will. He's done it before and he'll do it again. Come on, give God a praise if you can. I got to get through here today. Hallelujah. Keep doing what you're doing. Until God turn your situation. Job continues on his discord with his friends concerning his state of affairs. And if anybody ever went through, Job really showed up, went through. But I noticed something. There was a verse that I noticed that I want to pay a particular attention to. Somebody just turn back all the way to verse chapter 13 of the book of Job. I didn't want to read all of that. But I just wanted to get to this part. Because I'm trying to encourage somebody to keep doing what you're doing until God turns your situation around. Job could have very easily aborted the process and cursed God and did and said a whole lot of other stuff and beat Eliphaz up and beat Bildad up and beat the other Zophar up for coming and talking to him like that. What you mean I done done something? How dare you come and accuse me? Y'all know I've been an upright man all my life. And when you done came to my house, thank you. And you will talk about me in my house. And you see me sitting here with all these boys on me and seeing from my head to my toes. What do you mean I done done something? But the thing about that really got me is that God never spoke to Job.
He never did.
While he was doing what he was doing.
My God, ain't that something?
And I said, God, at least you should have told him.
Yes, sir.
God, give him a hint or something. Let him know that you're going to bring him out. You're going to turn his situation around. But all Job can see is that I don't lost him.
Yes, sir.
Good God Almighty. And sometimes we lose little things about it. But if you got God, you got enough to start on looking. So keep doing what you're doing until God. Let me read my verse, okay? I got to get to my verse. As I was reading through this, Job begs God to speak to him. He desires an interview with God.
Yes, sir.
God, tell me what's going on. And God never really told him, but then Job began to say, God, you know, I don't understand what's going on, but God began to say, well, where were you when I stretched the heavens out like a curtain? Then you want to interview. Let's talk about this. And sometimes we want to talk to God like that. Lord, but then God reminds us, where were you when I formed you in your mother's womb? Even before you knew it. I knew you before you was even born. And where were we before we were born? We was with God. I knew you before you came out.
Amen.
And you're going to ask me what's going on?
Where were you
when I laid made the fountains of the deep and set a band around it where the water won't go over and override it. Where were you when I set the circle on the earth? He began to tell him what he had done. So Job said, all right. I'm sorry. Sometimes we got to tell God I'm sorry. Hallelujah. God, why did you allow this? I don't understand what you're doing, God. But then when it's all over and when the dust settles, we can look back and say, God, that was you.
That was you.
All along. That was you. That was you. You were there. And the footstep that I saw in the sand, that when I saw four, then all of a sudden I saw two. Then somebody wrote the story that I just saw two, but that was when God was carrying you. Oh, hallelujah. That's when God was carrying you. You stopped walking way back there because you had reached the end of your rope. But God said, I'm taking you up. I'll bear you up on eagle's wings. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So, God, I want to encourage you today. And as Job got through his suffering, look at verse 13. Though he slay me, he had come to the resolve that God, even if you kill me, what does he say?
Yes.
That will I trust you.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Don't trust me, but I will maintain. This is the part I want you to get.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to keep doing what I'm doing.
Mm-hmm.
He says, yeah, even though you kill me, I'm going to maintain. What does he say?
My ways.
What I'm doing,
yeah.
I'm going to keep on doing.
Mm-hmm.
He could have said, I'm not going to say anything about you no more. Look how you did me. Look how I look amongst my friends.
Mm-hmm.
You made my wife lose, almost go off on the deep end on me.
Mm-hmm.
You going to maintain?
Come on.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah. You going to keep on praying to me?
Yes.
You going to keep on asking and talking to me? You going to keep on trusting me?
Yes.
After you allow me this to happen to me?
Yes.
Joe says, even though you kill me, I'm going to maintain my ways. Amen. That means I'm going to keep on trusting you.
Yes.
I'm going to keep on believing in you.
Yes.
I'm going to keep on telling men about you. Even though you break me down, like somebody, Bermilla said, like a shotgun.
Yes.
Sometimes we say, click, click. We've been broken into pieces.
Yes,
my God. But then we say, I'm going to still trust God.
Yes.
Even though it looks bad on my part. I'm going to still trust you, even when I cannot trace you. He says in chapter 14, verse 14, if a man died, look at the integrity of Job.
Yes, sir.
And Job kept on doing what he was doing until God turned his situation around. If a man died, shall he live again?
Yes, sir.
All the days of my appointed time, I'm going to
wait
till my
change comes. Hallelujah.
Already.
That's faith, y'all.
Yes, sir.
Yes,
sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. All the days of my appointed time, I'm going to wait. So encourage somebody today.
Yes,
tell somebody, keep on praying.
Keep on praying.
Keep on believing.
Keep on believing.
Keep on trusting.
Keep on trusting.
God is going to turn things around for you.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Don't be weary in your well-doing.
Yes, sir.
For in due season, you will reap if you don't faint. Come on, give the Lord a praise. I'm going to pause right there. Hallelujah. Stand for a few moments. I want to pray for you today because I believe that this is a season that we all need some type of encouragement. Because sometimes we don't want to keep on praying because we prayed sometimes that we haven't received the answer as of yet.
Uh-huh.
And the enemy said, what are you praying for?
Uh-huh.
Maybe y'all never had that inner voice. That negative. How do you silence that negative inner voice that tells you to stop when God is all the time telling you to keep on going?
Yes.
But that inner voice that said, why are you praying? You see your situation doesn't match up to what it really should be. Why are you even going through this? Why are you believing and trusting God? You might as well just do like Job's mother and wife said, curse God and die. But Job said, I'm going to maintain, I'm going to keep doing, that's my own paraphrase. I'm going to keep doing what I'm doing until God turns the situation around. And when Job got the revelation, y'all read the lot of chapters of Job, God turned Job's situation around when he began to pray for his friends.
He had to pray for
him. He better had to. Thank you very much. Prayed for his friends. God turned around, gave him his children back, gave all of the stuff that he had lost, and gave him not only that, gave him double for his trouble. But suppose he had given up. Suppose he had thrown in the towel and said, God, you let too much. I couldn't take this. But guess what? God puts no more on us
Yes, sir.
Than we can bear.
That's what he said.
And if he allowed you to access you, then evidently he's going to give you the strength to go through. So bow your heads and close your eyes. I don't know who we're talking about today, but somebody is struggling about whether they should continue going forward or whether they should continue moving in a particular vein. But if God gives you the strength, keep doing what you're doing until God turns it around. It may be your children. It may seem like they want to go to hell anyway. And you've been praying for them, and it seems like instead of getting better, they're getting worse.
Hallelujah.
But keep on praying for them.
Yes.
Because if Job was in the example or in the indication, if you stay and if you maintain your ways, if you don't change up on God, God says, I'll turn it around for you.
Yeah.
God is testing you and allowing you to go through that for a reason.
Yes, sir.
And sometimes the reason is not even about us.
Mm-hmm.
It's about who we are attached to.
Yes, sir.
It could have very easily been to encourage Job's wife.
Yes.
Y'all hear something about
that. That's right.
It could have very easily because she didn't really understand what God was doing, and neither could Job understand.
That's right.
But God was turning it around.
Mm-hmm.
And I could see Job in my mind's eye. Say, girl, I told you. He won't turn it around.
Girl, I told you
he was going to turn it around.
My God.
So bow your heads and humble your heart. And I don't know what you're going through. It may be some financial situations that you're dealing with. And it may seem instead of things getting better, they're getting worse.
Mm-hmm.
And that's how things happen in life. And the darkest hour is just before the day.
Yes, sir.
But I can see the sun peeking through the cloud.
Mm-hmm.
The storm is almost gone. Somebody's been experiencing a storm in their lives. They don't know exactly when it's going to be over. But God is there. Even if he was with Paul and said shipwreck and going through his journey to Rome and seemed like the ship was going to be broken into many pieces. But yes, it was. It said, but God says, I be of good cheer.
Yeah.
I'm with you. There stood by me an angel of God this night and said, stay on the ship.
Yeah.
Hang in there. Keep doing what you're doing. Stay on the ship. And they made it to land on broken pieces.
Yes,
and boom. You may have to make it on broken pieces. I don't know who I'm talking to today. Hallelujah, but hang on in there. Keep on doing what you're doing. Father, in the name of Jesus. Oh, hallelujah, God, I thank you for blessing us now. Help us to maintain our ways. Help us not to throw in the towel. Help us to not get discouraged in our prayer life. Help us not get discouraged in our concentration, in our dedication unto you. But God, strengthen your people now. Allow the power of the Holy Ghost to overshadow them, Lord. In the name of Jesus. Oh, God, I know that you can. Look on that relational situation that seems out of control, that seems going in the wrong direction. God, you are able to turn it around for your glory, for your honor. God, turn it around as only you can. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Let them know that their suffering has an expiration date.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah. Let them know that if we're not many days hence, it'll all be over. Let them know, God, that you're there all the time. Lord, bless them now. Keep them in the name of Jesus. Don't allow the enemy to distract them. Get them off course. Touch them now. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Put a yes, Lord, down in their soul. Put a yes, Lord, down in their spirit, God. Tell them to keep doing what they're doing until you turn their situation around. And God will thank you for so doing. Hallelujah. We want to see what the end is going to be like. We want to see how to live a victorious life to the end, God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Glory to God. Lord, do it for your glory. Do it for your name. Say, God, we won't take any of your credit.
Yes.
But God, you are able. You are turning around even now.
Yes, sir.
Our situations, our circumstances, that are, God, we don't know exactly what to do.
Yes.
But even if you did for Job, God, you can do it for us.
Yes.
And even though we die, God, we know that in our flesh we shall see you.
Yes.
Bless these people now in the name of Jesus. Help them to maintain their integrity.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Even though those that are there at the end of their rope, give them the hold on, God.
Yes.
The hold on to your hold to your hand.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus, we do decree it and declare it now that it is so.
Yes.
And so it is. We claim it by faith.
Hallelujah.
By faith. We walk by faith and not by sight.
Hallelujah.
We thank you now for your blessings upon the life.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, we pray.
Yes.
And all the people of God said, amen.
Amen.
Come on, let's give the Lord a praise that we can see. Glory to God. Glory to God. Listen, it won't always.